post-election violence, 2007, December and January. It was such a short time, but a lot happened in this country. Everything stopped, and tension and just feeling challenged, like, are we going to come back where we were? And not being certain of how the day, the next day would look like. That was the environment. We felt challenged, some of us, to find space to do something within that conflict. We picked Mathare North.
We didn't even pick, yeah. We were told we would pick
Mungiki
was going to send tenants to be flashed out because they had refused to pay rent.
And there was actually an incident. A landlord who wanted to get some tenants out of his property. And that attempt was counterproductive in a way because the group that was sent, alleged to be Mungiki, the community members, the groups, the youths in that community fought back. And there are few people who died in that incident. So when we heard there were more of that was to come, we thought then this would be too much of actually just observing, and we thought of intervening.
We met with the landlords. They were raising money in order to hire Mungiki, where they can go and kill and flash. So we remember Rosie.
Yeah.
Rosie was a young lady who worked in the office, and her father was a landlord in Mathare. So we asked her to get her father to convene the other landlords.
We were working in Huruma, but not Mathare North. And therefore, going to Mathare North was symbolic because it was also where it's next to ghetto.
The major challenge of Mathare North is that most of the landlords, you remember Kim, were Kikuyu?
Yes, all of them.
And most of the tenants were Luos.
Yeah.
And the Kikuyu landlords were saying that the Luos had refused to pay their rent.
Yes.
So they had organized themselves into a strong association.
Yeah.
The intention was to raise money,
yes,
to hire young youths to go and flash out the tenants so they can get back their properties. So obviously it was going to be a major plan, So now we started, found ways of getting to that landlord's association, and we started talking to them, and somehow we persuaded them that they needed to go through an arbitration process. So we said, you landlords, organize yourself, have your representatives, and you tenants, because we were also working with the tenants.
Yes.
You tenants, organize yourselves, and then we'll have a mediation. You talk, just talk. So we managed to get a Kikuyu mediator, a retired Anglican bishop called Jenga, and then we also got a Piata, who was a lawyer.
And the head of Hakichami.
Who at least the tenants would have confidence in, because he's a Luo. And so we started having these mediation meetings.
In the beginning it was like, it's not going to be easy to get people to come.
Mm.
And that's why we were using everyone we knew, who was close to us, who knew someone, who knew a landlord somewhere, and someone in the line of tenants who knew the most troublesome tenant, or the ringleaders or sort, to come to the table. Because then it wasn't just bringing everyone. There were those that really mattered in that reconciliation. And one attempt, of course, was for us physically to go to Mathare North to try and talk to them. Talk to the young people of the importance of really negotiations or trying to talk to each other. And we sat in this meeting, myself, Jane, and Opiata. They start moving in, getting in, and slowly they're like, who are you? It starts, unfortunately, by our names betraying us. Joseph Kimani, what do you do? It's very intimidating situation, trying to be very polite, smiling. It was actually very shocking to know that people really follow. They relate politics with very small details, to that extent. But then we were able to get out of it slowly, talk to them. And of course, our confidence helped us because it expressed that we were really had good intentions to reach out to them and to bring peace. And even them, some of them wanted that peace.
The vernacular media, especially the radio stations, were the ones that were funding the conflict. So they kept, you know, preaching hate, they kept... And so we realized that this conflict, the whole conflict was not going to end until the vernacular media stations were persuaded to talk another language. So what Biden did is that he managed to organize all the vernacular media stations in the country, and we would hold workshops with them. They were spoken to by a lawyer about the risk of them going to The Hague. And I said, you know, you guys, this is not a joke. You are playing with fire. Mm-hmm. And they went through that. And then we held other workshops. We had about 6 workshops. It was about community people coming to share their stories about the effects of the conflict. Mm? So one of the stories that was shared was, he was called Owino,
yes,
from Mathare North. And he told us how he was married to a Kikuyu woman. And at one point, some Kikuyu youths had come into their building and were knocking from door to door, looking for Luo tenants and
flashing them out,
beating them, just basically causing chaos. So then they listened. Owino listened with his wife, who was a Kikuyu, and he said, they're speaking in Kikuyu. So they said, okay, when they come, wife, you open the door. So Owino hid in the house, and when they knocked on the door, his wife opened. So they checked, she spoke to them in Kikuyu, they left. After a while, I think after a few days, another gang came.
The retaliation
from Luo youths. So they listened. Said, these are Luo youths. So they said, Owino, you open the door. I will hide. So he hid, the wife hid. And then Owino opened the door. And he spoke to them in Luo. And they left. So these are the stories that the people from the slums were telling the media. I'm married to a Kikuyu woman. So there's no conflict. You're the ones who are causing this conflict. And over time, they were persuaded. In fact, they all agreed that they would air peace messages right throughout the country. And the tone of the media changed.
There was one other remarkable outcome from the peace meetings played out in Mathare. Because this is the time when we were entering Mathare and trying to help the Federation spread and consolidate. So in one incident, after these meetings now in the office, trying to bring residents together in Kosovo, when an operation was happening at night, it was an operation of youth. They were going from settlement to settlement. They had started in Kiamu, were going to village 2. Now they were in Kosovo. In Kosovo, they reached out to this old man, got his things out, and they were almost burning them when Muungano in the settlement intervened. And they said, this is not the way to go. We will stop this. We will not allow anyone to be evicted here by force or to be harassed. We must live as one community. And that touched that person a lot. He became the chairman of Muungano in that settlement, Mr. Otieno. And it has been his story of how really the peace meetings assisted in rescuing him and his family from almost being killed. So they continued in Bondeni. It involved healing. Yeah? Even just Muungano member saying, we accept what happened, we know who did. Mm? Someone just observing her 13 animals, goats, being slaughtered. And later saying, I have no grudges, I forgive those who did this, I know them, but we'll move on. Yeah? In my view, one group that I really came to like in terms of systems, savings, and was Toy Market. The membership had almost reached 3,000. The story of Toy in our spread for encouraging and giving hope to other settlements was really helping a lot. When you would go and say there is a group that saves money daily, and they have a system where you can borrow money daily, 24 hours, you know, you borrow in the morning, do your business during the day, and in the evening you return that money. Organized in clusters, in such systematic, and the way they also attracted banks to come, just relocate Equity coming close to Kibera because of toy market and the system that was also happening there. But when the clashes happened, it split. It split people who were very close, almost to be one family. Split completely, torn apart.